We just spent some time visiting three different... Can everyone hear me with the mask? Is that okay if I keep it on? Are good? Okay. We spent some time visiting three different parts of the hospital here and talking with senior leadership about the incredible strain on our healthcare system that this pandemic continues to put on our first responders, on our healthcare workers. And so we were able to visit with those staff at the medical intensive care unit, which has been absorbing so much of the immediate intensive issues with COVID-19. We stopped by the emergency department, and we were also able to visit the testing center around the corner and outside. So I want to thank Dr. Tarnoff for having us here, and my colleagues, Chairman Michaelowitz from the State House, President Flynn from City Council. I'll pass it over to them to say a few words and then take questions.
I just want to thank you all for being here. Had the chance to meet the mayor just a few weeks ago, extended this invitation, as well as to Chairman Michaelowitz and Councilman President Flynn. And I'm just so grateful. When the mayor asked me what the city could do, I said one of the foundational things would be to just come make rounds with us and meet our healthcare workforce and just listen and hear what's happening. And they did that. And I couldn't be more grateful for the time that we just got to spend. And I'm thankful for the opportunity that we were able to give them to hear directly from our healthcare workforce about the status of the pandemic. So thank you all.
So I just want to thank the mayor for organizing today and for Tufts for having us and getting a good vantage point of what exactly is going on right now on the front lines. I want to also thank Tufts in particular for their walk-in services that they have for their testing site. I have personally taken advantage of it a couple of times, and it's comforting to know to have that facility in the city of Boston, in my district here in Chinatown, and for many people to access it at any point in time. So I want to thank Tufts for all their work that they are doing there. So thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Wu, for bringing us together during this difficult time. What's important is Boston comes together. It's going to take hard work and discipline, and that means getting vaccinated, getting tested, putting a mask on, following public health guidelines, and everyone needs to be part of the solution. And we just came by here today to say thank you to our medical professionals for the outstanding work that they're doing on behalf of the residents of Boston. So just want to say thank you to the mayor of Boston for bringing us together and for the important leadership she's providing. Thank you.
So I just want to, my two main takeaways from this visit were, first, that our healthcare workers are incredible. For 2 years now, they have been on the front lines putting everything they have into the care of our most vulnerable friends, family, and neighbors. But they are also exhausted. The second takeaway is that many of the hospitalizations, the vast majority, are of residents who are unvaccinated, and many of these are completely preventable if people get vaccinated and get boosted. And so our message here today is one of deep thanks to everyone who has been at the front lines during the pandemic, and one also that we will continue on the city side to work on policies that will boost vaccination rates, to make testing and booster clinics and vaccine clinics available, so that we can help ease the strain on these incredible staff and workforce who are here at Tufts and across our healthcare system. Questions? The number one step is to increase vaccination rates across the city. Next Friday, our policies go into effect. The Be Together program means that everyone who will be entering a restaurant or indoor dining facility, an entertainment facility, or an indoor exercise gym facility will need to show proof of vaccination. This means that we are keeping our workforce safe, we're keeping our customers safe. At the same time, the City of Boston's own workforce will increase the protections available as we move for full vaccination of city workers as well.
Mayor, the White House announced today that it's expanding the FEMA testing program in more states. And so far, Massachusetts has not been one of them. Are you getting in touch with our federal delegation or federal authorities about why Massachusetts is involved in it? It's not getting any federal help to test it.
I have not and will, so thank you for pushing that. I'm in close contact with our state officials, and some of them are here today, to make sure that we're doing everything we can from all sides to make testing more available. This is a national shortage. This is a problem that is not just in Boston, but all across the country. here we want to show and model what we can do. So even just this week, the city of Boston has opened new testing sites that are walk-in in our neighborhoods. We are moving towards a high-capacity site, and so we look to continue partnering for the funding and investments that will make that possible. We are also looking to manage the lines and have tents and heaters at some of these locations as well, so that people aren't subject to hours and hours of waiting in the cold, which is completely unacceptable. We know that at the end of the day, testing is not necessarily something that you can book, right? You are not feeling well that day, or we were in the Tufts testing site and a family with two young girls told me in Mandarin that they were, the little girls were subject to an exposure because someone else in their childcare program tested positive recently. They needed to get tested before they could go back. That's not something that necessarily our appointment only spots can address. So we need more walk-in capacity across the city.
Will tents or heaters be available by Friday? We're expecting to get several
snowplows. As of today, we've already put tents at the Anacole Testing Center in Jamaica Plain. We're looking to do that at many of our testing sites that are run by the City of Boston as well. But we are, again, I think there's a balance between having many, many neighborhood sites, which are often smaller. We need that geographic access across the city. But if you go to one site and the line is very long when the two sites in other neighborhoods are empty, in some ways we have to move towards a high capacity location as well where people know they can come in for a walk-in appointment and be seen.
Mayor, can you give an update for how many BTS staff are out?
As of today, it was over 1,000 staff, including about 750 teachers.
And what's the general outlook in terms of...
650 teachers.
In terms of the likelihood of schools remaining open, what's that outlook look like right now?
Yeah. You know, our superintendent, I believe, is having her own avail later this afternoon. Superintendent Caselius was pulled into teaching a class herself today, along with many of our central staff senior administrators, because we are that short-staffed. We're taking this in a school-by-school basis to really work with principals, work with school leaders and educators to balance those needs. Some of our schools are experiencing more than a quarter of staff absent because of positive COVID tests or other issues. And so we are doing the best we can. It may get to the point where on a school-by-school basis, we may need to move to a snow day, which is the state policy. DESE currently is not allowing for any remote learning whatsoever, even if it is due to staffing shortages. And so we continue to talk with them about the rigidity of that policy. And also, we are expecting a snowstorm potentially Friday. So there's lots in the mix about how we're managing the logistics and operations of the schools.
Mayor, we went out to Melnia Pass Rec Center today to see like the state's new vaccination booster site was busy. There were a lot of people coming in and out, and I assume you're happy to hear about that.
Absolutely. Do you want to talk about state testing, state sites?
I know that's something new that we just started and something that we're, you know, looking forward to seeing what the results are. Hopefully, you know, it continues to increase the vaccination, not just here in the city of Boston, but also that people take advantage of it from across the state as an opportunity.
I would just say it's critical that each organization does their part to provide as much testing as they can. Tufts is doing an exceptional job, but we need others across the city to step up to provide testing throughout all the neighborhoods of Boston.
Can I add one thing before? Sorry. Which is that I do want to highlight and thank Tufts as well. Not only are their workforce putting in the very intensive work that all of our hospitals and health centers are, they are the only academic teaching hospital that is offering walk-in testing, and this has been true for basically the entirety of the pandemic. Our city workers have come here to get tested and vaccinated, especially our public safety and first responders, and so they've been performing a huge service in the community. I also want to add that we know this is working. We've been putting resources into increasing the number of sites, managing and increasing the capacity at these sites, and we have been seeing our vaccination rates go up in recent days and weeks in Boston. The rate of the percentage of folks who have been boosted has jumped up as well. So the mobile clinics work, the clinic at first night has worked, the appetite and demand is out there, so we just need to continue meeting that. Dr. Tarnoff.
President Tarnoff, could I just ask you about the situation at your facility?
Yeah. Thanks for the question. We're managing our throughput, but it's difficult every day. It's difficult every hour. It's part of why we asked the mayor and team to come visit and connect with our organization. We have a perfect storm of COVID surge, and while we're seeing high viral numbers, we preferentially are seeing less hospitalizations and ICU admissions, but with the statistics as high as they are, hospitalizations and ICU admissions are still a day-to-day constant issue for us. When you connect that to the staffing constraints that have been well publicized and the number of employees, much like the mayor just mentioned with the state, that we have out sick today, complex with the idea that we have a lot of patients with high acuity care that are not even COVID related from the viral perspective, but just from the delay of health care and the presence of high acuity illness in our facility, it's a day-to-day, hour-to-hour management crisis. And we need all the help we can get from the public to do what the mayor said. Please get vaccinated. Please get boosted. Please wear your mask. It's all you can do to help us. And this clearly, from a COVID viral perspective, is now a disease of the unvaccinated. And that is preventable, and it needs to end. The delaying of care that we're having to do for otherwise healthy patients who are trying to come in for health care is only making the situation worse over a prolonged period of time. And every time we have to delay care for patients that need it, they get sicker, and that burdens the system further.
Do you have a wait for beds at this point?
That changes day to day and hour to hour. The throughput is better at some moments than it is at others. We generally do have backups in our emergency department, as other hospitals have reported, and we have had to postpone procedures and other parts of care to try to create staffing elements that basically support the patients and the need that we have here to maintain safe care and high quality care. But on any given day, at any given hour, there can be waits in our emergency department and in other portions of our healthcare system where patients are trying to get in and just face that burden of everything that I just described.
Do you have a percentage of how many of the cases are vaccinated, of the hospitalizations are vaccinated?
Yeah, let me ask Dr. Boucher to address that.
Sure. So most of the admitted patients with COVID are unvaccinated, and of those sick enough to be in the intensive care unit, the vast majority, almost 90%, are unvaccinated. So the number one thing you can do for yourself, your family, and the community is to get that vaccine. I'm so heartened to hear that people got vaccinated today. And if you're eligible, get a booster. We know that the booster and the vaccine prevents against serious illness and death, and that's going to help us be able to care for the patients who need us, those with COVID and those with other things. So really, really important. And two other things I'll mention. One is it's not too late to get your flu shot. We're seeing influenza. And don't go to work or school if you're sick. That's the best gift you can give to your colleagues, and that's going to get us all back to normal faster. Thanks. Can I just reiterate that very, very important point, which is that gaps in vaccination rates are affecting everyone. Those who are unvaccinated, of course, who are ending up as 90% of the most intensive and at-risk hospitalizations, but also everyone else who might need care at any other point. If you are looking to get a hip replacement, if you have some other procedure that has been bothering you but is not an emergency, these are getting pushed back, and we are seeing the ripple effects on everyone as we drag this out without closing vaccination rates. And so Boston needs to show clear leadership. What we've been doing has been working. We've been seeing the rates coming up. I'm looking forward to implementation of our policies next Friday, which will again, we'll see a jump in vaccination rates, and that helps every single person in our community.
Mayor, tomorrow is the one-year anniversary of the insurrection at the Capitol. I'm just wondering if you have an update for the investigation into a potential presence of Boston cops at that insurrection. It's been a year. Is that investigation still ongoing, and if so, why?
It is ongoing, and I will look into it and report back.
Do you have anything to say to the protesters that were at the State House saying you're heartless and don't care about people?
The staff and the people... No. We walked through so many floors of this hospital where the most big-hearted and generous and resilient people anywhere in our city are taking care of those who are sick and those who have preventable illness. And so anything that we can do to make their lives easier, to boost vaccination rates, to keep every single person in our community safe, is what we can best do to take care of each other.
I think you'll be okay with the unions. I know they filed suit to block mandate for city workers.
We are moving forward with our policies, and we are confident that we have been in ongoing conversations with all of our city workers and believe that they will join us in doing the right thing and making sure that we help protect our entire city and keep us safe.
How confident are you that Boston can ramp up the supply of testing so folks aren't standing in lines for hours?
Well, we're working for a partnership with the state and federal government, and there's been incredible buy-in and movement on all those fronts as well. This is going to be an ongoing issue, and so we are opening up more sites in the city, and some of this will be managing lines better and putting information out so it's clear what the wait times are at different spots. We need to get better on the logistics of this as well. Great. We mostly spoke with staff today. Again, we were in the testing center and ran into a few families there who were interested in chatting. And it was you could see the stress on their faces. There's one family with two little girls, one who was crawling around the floor, and they were having to keep her in their arms. And I know what that feels like, to have a very heavy little child in your arms that you don't want to be there, but you need to be there to keep them safe and to keep everyone safe. So we're doing all we can with our patients and our residents just like that in mind. Good. Anyone need Spanish? We're okay. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.